I'm very proud to say, I think we're the only minority serving institution that is competing in this global competition. And I think it's so important for our students to really be at the cutting edge, recognizing that this hasn't been solved yet, but could have an enormous impact. The idea of an avatar that could help one transport their physical presence remotely has a lot of potential. Our lab was really birthed after 9/11. For more than 20 years, our lab has focused on disaster response and humanitarian assistance. That's kind of our mantra in this lab. Whether it was Hurricane Katrina, whether it was, you know, Fukushima, this idea of an avatar, a robot agent, really takes it to the next level.
The complexity of this when we compare with other competitions is that none of our trained roboticists and engineers will be in charge of the machine. And people don't understand that. So this competition is difficult because we have to trust a $1 million robot to a random judge that has never used the system before. So that person has full control of our machine for 25 minutes. And the key of succeeding is training. Because remember, at the end of the day, we're trying to build a technology that can be used by anyone. My goal in this competition is to advance avatar telepresence embodiment technology. In other words, allowing firefighters to step in on a VR suit, and then all of a sudden they can do the same thing, perform a safe location. Surgeons, with this technology, a doctor can perform multiple surgeries in different countries. That is the potential of the technology. That's what makes me very excited about it.
Right before when robot falls or freaks out, there is inconsistencies in data and we are constantly monitoring it. So after it falls and destroys itself, we take those data, it's like a black box, and we take it and we spend days analyzing it. We try to figure out what caused it to fall. And the next time when we test it, we make sure to fix those issues. There was this one occasion where we were testing the system for the first time when the robot wasn't connected to gantry or any power cables or Ethernet cables. It was on its own, off the gantry, on the floor. When it moved, that was like that moment where like was the best one, because I will never forget it. The robot was able to like wave and shake people's hand without being tethered. That I would say the best moment.
We're putting a lot of our heart into this, just the desire to make UNLV in Las Vegas proud, and to kind of really show that there is a lot of technological potential in this city. So it's something that, you know, becomes something they could tell their children or their children's children, that they were, you know, a footnote in the history of the development of robotics.